Well, thanks for watching this video. In this video, I'm going to talk about QuickBooks bank feeds. I'll show you tips and tricks on how to bulk categorize expense transactions in QuickBooks Online. It's a huge time-saving technique, and we have lots of bank downloaded transactions. You know, and I said lots, we're talking 500,000, you know. And you want to do the bulk categorization instead of doing one at a time. So there's a technique that you could use in QuickBooks Online. So I will show you that. So that's the focus of this video. So I'm going to go to QuickBooks Online, and we're going to go over this. Okay, so this is QuickBooks Online. You know, this is just a demo thing. You know, in this case, I have, as you can see here, I have 551 downloaded transactions. If you just do one at a time, it's going to take a lot of time. So I'm going to do bulk categorization. Okay, so the first thing you do is when you look at the bank transactions in here under banking, you know, the downloaded transactions. But it could be date, you know, you can sort, so it could be the latest one first. It's doing it, see, the 331 first, or it could be 131. In this case, that's when the download started. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is you need to go to this middle gear icon. This is where you have all the time-saving techniques, you know, for this. You know, in this case, only 551. Let's say you're doing it for the whole year. It could be 2,000 or more than that. So just think about that. And so this is the video that will save you time. So, so click this middle gear. And in this case, you will see all these, you know. And it's possible you may have only 50, you know, if you have only 50 and you have to categorize thousands, you know, or 500, it's better to do it 300, you know. And on a monthly basis, if you're doing it every day, then you can just do 50 and categorize it. But in this case, you have 551, so it's better to select 300. Okay, and then you can select the enable suggested categorization. So what this will do is QuickBooks will do some intelligence thing and will suggest to you, well, if you go to Home Depot, well, we think this is, you should go to this account, you know. And they have done a pretty good job here. So just you know, look at it. And if you don't like it, if you want to do categorization to some other account, you can always change it. And other thing you want to do is so the bank details in here, you know. So the bank details, just click this one. Okay, and then you want to copy that bank details to memo so that when you add, it will go to QuickBooks register. So let's say you went to Costco and bought something, you know, most of the bank transactions will give you some more detail, you know, so it will copy and it goes to your general ledger. Okay, the other one, you can show tag field or enable data field, that's all right. And show amounts in one column, it's basically, you know, it's a spent, received, that's two columns. And if you just want to do one column, you can just select one column like this. And now it's basically just amount, and it will give you a more more field, more space for the description and vendor and payee. And and you also want to select payee, you know. The reason is, I'll show you why, but you select this. And so pay right here. So if you want to do expense tracking, what you bought from Costco or Home Depot for the whole year, or ongoing basis. So you need to have this one selected. And the key here is this one is groups. Turn on grouping. So this is the very huge time-saving feature. If you have tons of items you need to categorize. So do this, okay, select that one, and you will see the magic now. Okay, so now it's basically, it's as it is, it will basically is categorizing by month. So in January, you have 189, and then come down, and you will see the next month, February 111, and so on. Okay, so the bulk categorization, what you need to do is you need to find out. Normally, you will see pay. In this case, it's brand new. We haven't signed any pay yet. So what you need to do is click this description one. You want to sort by description. See what happens in here. Okay, so as you can see here, is Amazon. We have 90 transactions. And expenses is going to be negative in here, like this here. This is a checking account. And if it's on the credit card account, you will see positive for the charges, and payments can be negative because it's a liability. Okay, so we're just using one column, and you'll have more real estate space here. Okay, so all you need to do is select this Amazon 90. See right here? And you don't want to confirm it at this point because you haven't assigned the payee yet. So what you need to do is you select update, and they have already assigned QuickBooks, you know, they have already assigned whatever you buy from Amazon, it goes to supplies. And if you think that's not accurate, you want to put it in some other place, you can change it. Okay, so I'm just going to select update. Okay, there's a transaction type, this is expense. And the payee in this case is Amazon. All right, add, because you're creating a new vendor pay name in here. And customer, it's the type is not customer, it's always expenses, always vendor. Expense, vendor, deposit, coming from your sales, from your customers, is customer. So in this case, it's vendor. And so select that one. And in this case, it goes to supplies. Okay, just see supplies in your supplies and materials, you know, or just supplies. All right, I'm just going to select supplies in this case. All right, so then I'm going to click apply and confirm. So it's because the bank now download it, it's not in the QuickBooks. So you need to categorize to have these transactions in your QuickBooks general ledger accounts. Okay, so apply and confirm. So second time a little bit. Okay, it's asking, hey, you buy items from Amazon a lot. Do you want to create a rule? So next time, you know, you'll save your time. It'll automatically go to, you'll select Amazon as pay, and it go to that account category. And in this case, you know, in the future, you don't have to worry about it. You can still review it later on, but just say, auto confirm. Say the auto confirm or this non auto confirm means you can categorize pay and account category, but I still want to see the transaction itself, you know. So in this case, I want to auto confirm and then create rule. Okay, so what happened to that? All those transactions, where did it go? Okay, so now I'll show you where it went. Okay, it's all expenses. Let's select this. This the left navigation bar. It's a new one. It's a little bit different. Bookmarks thing. Okay, in your case, you will see expenses and vendors, expenses. Okay, so these are the expenses that you can see here. You know, right here. So everything in right here. See, supplies. Okay, and if you select the vendors, let's see if they have vendors too. Vendors. Okay, save that one. So go to vendors, and right here, Amazon. So right here, these are expenses. As you can see here, whatever you bought from Amazon, we all went to the same account, you know. And let's say, hey, I don't want the supply, I want some other different accounts, you can select all, you can select all like this, or just select one or two, whatever you want, right here, like this. And underneath basket actions, you can categorize selected items and select the accounts you want, whatever accounts you want, you know. That's also bulk categorization, you know. Just, you know, if you don't like this account, that's why it's very important you sign Amazon or, you know, or a vendor and payee when you categorize those transactions. Otherwise, it won't show up here. And if you want to recategorize it, you will have to do it one at a time. You have to open it. And then change the, you know, the account category. In this case, you won't have the vendor in here. So that's why it's you know, it's huge time saving if you have Amazon as a vendor. You know, you need to assign vendor. And it keeps in track of all the expenses in one place too, you know. Okay, so now we'll go back to the banking again. So you're starting to get some idea now. All right, so I have so we have about 461. All right, let's click description again. Okay, now we've got the Walmart in here. We've got to go to town and grouping. Normally we'll save it, you know, in this case. Oop. Okay. All right. Here's the Walmart one. We've got 59 items. Okay. You don't want to confirm it because you don't have pay yet. And supplies accounts fine. So update. This expense transaction is not a transfer from one bank account to another bank account. And pay is Walmart in here. You just have to assign this Walmart one time. The next time you can just select from this list in here. Okay. Walmart, make sure it's a vendor, not customer. And then supplies. Supplies. Okay. Or some other account. All right, this is fine. Just create rule. It'll save you tons of time next time. The bank feed will automatically categorize to those accounts. All right, so here's another one. See how easy it is. Now when we have a few left, expense, pay, this is the Lowe's, L-O-W-E-S. Oops. So now there's a problem. By mistake, I created this Lowe's as a customer. Now you can't create another one. So what you need to do is, in this case, I'll just create some other one. Let's say Lowe's like this, and then delete the other one. Okay, in this case is supplies, or it could be any other accounts if it's your job type, you know. Supplies, okay. All right, so if you want to delete that one, the other one, you just need to go to customers. So now you go in here and lows. You can't delete it, you just need to change it now. So let's say I want to just say delete this thing. All right, so it's gone now. It will just say delete, you know. Okay, you can make it inactive, but still, it will still be there. Okay, so now go to so go to bank transactions again. So you got an idea, now it's down to 312. You can do the same thing again. Okay, it's still downloading, it's kind of slow right now. All right, so this is the distributor one. So this is also supplies. All right, okay, so I'm gonna stop once I finish this one. Okay, so the vendor is LA distributor. So be careful to select the right type. And normally it will select vendor, but in this case it's a brand new one. So it's just, they don't know it's a vendor or customer. Okay, let's say in this case supplies and materials. Select that one, apply and confirm. Okay, so I'm going to stop right now, and then you can, you know, you got an idea how to categorize all these. The key here is go to the middle gear here and select, you know, all these, whatever you need, turn on grouping, you know. Okay, and then select if it's you have a huge tons of transactions you need to categorize, you know, you can select the 300, you know, that's the max. Okay, so basically for review, it goes to categorize, and when you say categorize, it goes to the bank register, you know. So if you click it here, you'll see all those transactions we have categorized. See all these? It's already here. Okay, and now all you have to do is see the report where it went. So it basically went to the same bank register in here. So it's all right here, see? So it's in QuickBooks now. So it's downloaded. That means it's not in QuickBooks register yet. It's just downloaded for your review. You know, you have all the data, but it's not in QuickBooks, and now it's in QuickBooks. Okay, and now let's see here.